Hello, everybody. Don't look at the hair, right? It's 100 degrees outside. Come on, toy. You guys see what I have put up with?
Cut.
All right. It's 100 degrees outside. I just got done making sure all the plants were in the shade, helping the little toads get out of the sun into the rock garden stuff, so sweaty. But I came in, took a shower, or not just shower, but washed my hands. But Dwight, out in this 100 degree plus weather that feels like 105, is out there smoking a chicken. And I am going to prepare a cornbread that I saw on Facebook. I don't know who the publisher is, so I'm just going to say this is a recipe I found on Facebook. I've never tried it like this. The only thing I'm going to do different is I do not have a bundt pan at this time, so I'm going to cook it in a skillet. So we're going to start with 2 boxes of the Jiffy corn muffin mix straight into a bowl. Now, the Facebook says this is the best cornbread you're ever going to eat, and I don't know. Dwight makes some very mean cornbread. He makes good cornbread, so I'm going to compare it to his. 1 can of cream-style corn, straight in. One can of drained regular corn, straight in. 1 corn in this, so get a new spatula. 1 cup of sour cream, whatever you like. Low fat, fat free, sugar free. Don't spill it on your cabinet like I just did. 1 pesky little fly flying around. Must have followed us in. Get away from here. One cup sour cream. Chopped jalapenos, optional. Put in as many or as little as you like. That looks like about enough for us. Seeds and all. And about 1 cup of shredded cheddar cheese. That's it. No eggs, no milk, no oil. Let's give it a good mix. Plus, I have an oven preheated in the back at 350 degrees, making it much more hotter in the house than it needs to be. We're crazy. But this sounded like something that would go really good with Dwight's smoked chicken, and he can truly smoke a great chicken. I don't know how he gets it in those little wrappers. He's not even laughing. I thought that was a funny joke.
Put it in a pipe.
He puts it in a pipe. Smokes a chicken. Okay, that looks well mixed to me. They put theirs in a bundt pan at 350 for 45 minutes. I do not have a bundt pan right now. I'm gonna put it in a skillet. I'll be right back. I'm on my tippy toes. That's how short I am. Jeez. Trying to get all of this in there. Why it didn't sizzle, I don't know, because this is hot. I'm just gonna even it out. I We have about 45 minutes left on the chicken. This is going to take 45 minutes in the hot oven.
Well, Linda has surpassed my meatloaf. She's getting ready to surpass my cornbread. Looks like it's about time that I can retire from cooking.
That's not true. Dwight's a great cook. He cooks a great meatloaf, great salmon patties, awesome smoked chicken, the best candied yams. And today he showed me a secret. He said, "Oh, Linda, look how many recipes I have saved." He's got like 100 recipes saved, I think, in this thing called All Recipes. I said, "Well, you're going to do the next 20 videos, but here I am doing the next one." So, but he's going to get behind the apron, which I'm not wearing today. I forgot to put my apron on. But anyway, he's going to be cooking some recipes. So we'll be back in about 45 minutes, and I'll let you know which is better, this cornbread or Dwight's cornbread.
Well, this has to be better. It's got cheese in it.
We'll see. See if this is ready. Woo! Gosh, dang, that's heavy. Get out of here, fly. Okay. Well, it smells wonderful. It appears to be done around the edges anyway. I'm gonna say that the cornbread is done. It smells amazing. It looks great. We brought the chicken in about 15 minutes ago.
I don't know if you can see that on the camera, but the temperature is right at 310 degrees.
That's pretty. Oh yeah. That's gorgeous. Ooh, that smoke. Definitely done.
What's the temperature?
I took it out at 166.
All right. So we're gonna take this in the house and let it rest. Well, but the cornbread finishes up.
Go ahead, keep. I'll try to get it in there. Turn that big, beautiful piece of wood.
We're gonna shut it down. Let me get that door for you. Well, I can't keep up with her. Here's Ronnie. He's following his nose. We're going to leave the aluminum foil on it because
I want to let them look at it, how beautiful you can.
Well, I mean, you know, it's a chicken. One thing I can guarantee you is that it is juicy.
It looks wonderful.
When you stick the thermometer in there, juices just run out.
The cornbread has 13 minutes to go.
All right, we shall return.
And so it's had plenty of time to rest. I'm gonna let Dwight carve the chicken. Then we're gonna cut into the cornbread and let's see how it all tastes. First, let's get something to put the chicken on. good knives are packed.
I left us a good knife. Video is rolling. I'm really not good at this, but I'll do the best I can, I guess.
I would say take it off the thing and stick it straight into the bowl here. I forgot I was holding the camera and I'm just moving it everywhere. Here, you want me to hold this? We are pros. Everybody watches this channel because we know what we're doing.
Ooh, it's hot.
Okay. I could afford to fix that for you, but I'm retired. All right.
Well, we got a leg right about here.
And I mean, to me, it's going to taste the same no matter how you cut it. Ronnie, what are you doing?
That's for somebody right there.
Well, that's got a lot of seasoning on it. We'll cut you off a piece of meat, Ronnie.
Oh, he likes the seasoning.
Ronnie, come here. Sit. Sit. Whoops, good grief. Yeah, we're great at our video skills and
carving skills. Well, the positive point is that it's so tender, the meat falls off the bone.
I mean,
and it is juicy.
It sure looks very juicy, and it looks I just love the look of the skin. The seasonings are all in there.
Let's see if we can get this wing.
I always go for a drumstick and a wing are my first two choices, and then I go for the breast. This has been smoking for how long, Dwight?
Between 3.5 and 4 hours.
4 hours at 350?
No.
300.
It started at about 275, and I slowly worked it up to about 300.
Okay, so 300. The cornbread was cooked at 350. For 45 minutes. Again, a recipe from Facebook. They do theirs in a bundt pan. I didn't have a bundt pan. I can't wait to cut into that and see what it tastes like.
Well, the thing to remember is that with the creamed corn, with the sour cream and the regular corn, it's gonna be real moist.
And the cheese.
Cheese might add some moisture. It sure might.
I'm interested. I've never put sour cream and cheese inside my... I've put the cream corn and the regular corn, but I've never added sour cream and cheese, so...
I had an old neighbor taught me the cream corn secret, and I never made cornbread again without it. I substituted cream corn for milk.
Right, since Dwight's been making it with cream corn and jalapenos, I mean, to me, that's fantastic. So we'll see. Will we keep doing it that way, or will we keep doing it this way? This is supposed to be a cornbread video, but we figured since we had the chicken smoking anyway, we're gonna just put it on there for fun. What the heck?
This is what you call bonus footage.
Bonus footage, there you go. Anything to help our poor little videos, right? The point is, we're trying our best, we're having fun doing it, and most of the time, it turns out.
It turns out.
That's a Ronnie piece right there. That's this piece right here. Oh, yeah. And I came back minus two fingers. No, I'm just kidding. Ronnie. That looks really amazing. You can see the... I don't know if the camera's going to show the moist...
glistening. Okay, so I'd say that's about enough footage of Dwight cutting the chicken. We'll be back.
We'll be back for the proverbial taste test.
So what do I do? Hit this red button up here?
Red button up
here. Okay, see, I know what I'm doing. Okay, so now Dwight has the chicken carved. Let's cut into that cornbread, shall we? It is definitely moist. Almost makes me feel like it's not cooked. It cooked for 45 minutes. I guess I will not be putting my, ooh, this is almost like a spoon cornbread, I'm guessing.
That would be fantastic. In the bottom of a bowl covered with a bunch of beans. Mm.
I don't know if it's the texture from the cream corn in there, the sour cream, all the cheese. When I inserted that knife, it came out clean, so I'm wondering, is this done? I had my honey and my butter already, but this looks pretty moist, so I'm gonna go ahead and taste it this way. I thought because the cornbread has been sitting here for about 15 minutes while Dwight carved the chicken and everything, maybe longer, that it wasn't going to be hot, and I didn't blow on it, so I just tasted it. And it burned, really burned my tongue. So, cut. That is actually really, really flavorful. It really packs a punch with all that cream corn, the corn niblets, the jalapenos you can definitely taste. But I would call this more of a, I think they call it like a spoon cornbread, almost like a cornbread pudding. It's definitely cooked, but it is so soft and so tender. Let me see if Dwight can show you the inside of that. I'm going to take a spoon of it. And the bottom, you can see, has a nice little crust on it. But it's definitely Style Switch Barbecue. When we went there, they had like a cornbread type pudding. So I definitely give it 2 thumbs up. It's delicious. If you like a soft cornbread that's more like a cornbread pudding, 2 thumbs up for this. If you like a regular cornbread that you can spread your butter and your honey on it, Dwight's cornbread is excellent with just the cream corn and the jalapenos, and it comes out like a regular cornbread. So here, let's go ahead and serve up a plate with some of Dwight's delicious smoked chicken. How's that for a Saturday afternoon? We'll let Dwight do the beauty shot of that beautiful cornbread. But like Dwight said, bonus footage of that wonderful smoked chicken. So definitely try this cornbread. It's delicious. Definitely 2 thumbs up. Thank you for watching. We're praying for everybody out there every day. I hope everybody's doing well. Be blessed. Have a great weekend. And enjoy the rest of your day.